Hi, my name is Rob, and in this video I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to learn the pentatonic scale patterns by approaching them in different ways. So you can learn them by heart with the least of effort, and more important, in a musical sense. Right after this. So, what is a pentatonic scale anyway? Well, we have to know what the essence of a pentatonic scale is and understand what makes it stand out from all the other scales you can choose from. See, a common scale is most often a seven-note scale and in most cases a diatonic scale, which means there are five whole steps and two half steps in any order. And that order determines the sound of the particular diatonic scale. Like, major scale is different from a minor scale, which is different from a Dorian scale. And that is different from a Lydian scale, and so on and so on. Now, a pentatonic scale is not a diatonic scale. And the main reason is that this scale lacks the half steps. It has only whole steps and third intervals. The word penta means five in Greek, and that gives away that the pentatonic scale is a five-note scale. Although a pentatonic scale is not a diatonic scale, as I just said, it still is derived from a diatonic scale. And in fact, it is a diatonic scale minus two notes. So let's take a look at the common C major scale, which is a seven-note diatonic scale. C, D, E, F, G, A, B. And it sounds like this. Now, to turn the C major diatonic scale into a C major pentatonic scale, we just have to ditch the fourth and seventh note, leaving us with these five notes, C, D, E, G, and A, which sounds like this. Well, this five-note scale with only whole steps and third intervals we call a pentatonic scale. Penta means five, a five-note scale. We can do the same for the minor key. So let's look at the diatonic A natural minor scale. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And it sounds like this. To create an A minor pentatonic scale, we'll just have to skip the second and sixth note and we'll end up with an A minor pentatonic scale with five notes and only whole steps and third intervals. Now you can do this for every major and every minor scale. For major scales, remove the fourth and seventh note from the diatonic scale, and for minor keys, ditch the second and sixth note to get a pentatonic scale. Now, because of those typical intervals, those whole steps and third intervals, the sound of a pentatonic scale is very specific and very typical. And if you play the scale the right way, you can hear that it originates from Asia. Of course, we know this scale as the number one choice for rock and blues guitarists on all over the world and on practically any level. In fact, it's pretty amazing what we can do with just five notes. Now, let's look at ways to learn those scale patterns and nail them as quickly as possible. Did you know there were five common patterns for the pentatonic scale to play over the whole neck of the guitar? Well, that's quite a lot to learn. And two of those five patterns are the most used patterns by any guitarist by far. And these patterns are the cornerstones of the pentatonic scale for guitar players all over the world. Now, let's look at the first minor pentatonic pattern. As you can see, the root lies on the sixth string underneath the index finger. It's the easiest pattern of all pentatonic patterns you can play, and it goes like this. There are tons of licks you can play with this pattern, and you'll find them in tons of videos scattered all over YouTube. We are going to play some of those licks later in this video too. And this is the second minor pentatonic pattern, which has the root on the fifth string beneath the index finger. And this pattern is a bit more difficult because of the half step shift on the second string. And it goes like this. Now, the first you need to get familiarized with is these shapes. And you can do that just by playing the shapes up and down the neck over a standard backing track. Preferable AQ Jamtrax backing track, of course. So do something like this in A minor. The first pattern is played in the fifth position. The root is A. Second pattern is played in the 12th position, and again the root is A. By the way, the link to this backing track is in the description. Both are easy to play and to remember. Now, as we've just seen, the root is either the first note on the 6th string or the first note on the 5th string, depending on the pattern, of course. Now, the notes starting from the root are exactly the same notes in both patterns, only an octave higher. Although the shapes are not the same, the notes are. And that's because the tuning of the guitar between the second and the third string consists of a third interval instead of a fourth between all other strings. A great way to learn and get familiar with these patterns is to learn where the root notes are located in both patterns and learn simple licks and try to copy the exact same lick from one pattern to the other. In this way, you're really going to understand these patterns in a musical sense and not just as a mechanical fingering pattern. So, let's find out where these root notes are hiding out in these patterns. The first pattern has three positions for the root. On the sixth, on the fourth, and on the first string. Now, put on a backing track in A minor and try to make very simple phrases from one root note A to the other, like this. And after a while, you just change the pattern and find out where the root notes are in that pattern. The second cornerstone minor pentatonic pattern has root notes on the fifth and on the second string. And that's it, only two root notes in this pattern. And again, we're going to play these patterns from one root note A to the other root note A, making very simple phrases. Doing so, you will get closer and closer to mastering these patterns, in both technical as in musical sense. Now that you know where the root notes are located in both patterns, we are going to play three licks and move them from one pattern to the other. And in this way, you'll get a sense of the meaning and sound of the notes in the different fingerings. This is lick number one in the first cornerstone pattern, followed by the lick in the second cornerstone pattern. And here's lick number two in the same way. And finally, lick number three, played in the same way. Of course, you can create your own licks and get inspired from others and do exactly the same thing. And when you've practiced all this, you will have enough knowledge of the cornerstone patterns of the minor pentatonic scale. Until now, we only spoke of the minor version of the pentatonic scale. And now we're going to explore the major version of the scale. And you have to understand that every pentatonic pattern is really both a minor and a major pentatonic scale. It just depends on which note you start. So it's time for a very short and easy piece of theory about the connection between the major and the minor scale. Okay, here we go. A minor scale is the scale that starts on the sixth note of a major scale. So when we look at the C major scale, which looks like this, we see that the sixth note of the scale is the note A. And when we started the scale on the sixth note instead of the first note, we are creating an A minor scale. So the C major scale and the A minor scale are very much connected. They use exactly the same notes, only the starting point is different, resulting in a different sounding scale. And we call these scales relative scales. The A minor is the relative minor scale of C major. And the same goes for other keys. Like E minor is the relative minor scale of the G major scale. They use the same notes. And B minor is the relative minor scale of the D major scale. Also the same notes. And so on and so on. So the A minor pentatonic scale, which we use throughout this video, has the same five notes as the C major pentatonic scale. A minor pentatonic and C major pentatonic are connected. They are relative scales. And if we start the first pattern we've learned on the note A, then we are playing an A minor scale. But if we start exactly the same pattern on the note C, then we are playing a C major pentatonic scale. Simple as that. Fortunately, there is a convenient guitar neck trick to remember this. For the pentatonic pattern, you just have to learn this rule. The root note of the minor pentatonic scale is always a minor third lower on the neck of the same string. So that's four frets lower. Now look at the first cornerstone pentatonic pattern. If you place your index finger on the root, in this case the note A, and you divide your fingers over the next frets, then your little finger will be on the major scale root, in this case the note C. So this pattern can be used for both A minor and C major chord progressions. And in practice it really depends on the chords that are played underneath your improvisation. The pattern will sound major over a C major chord progression and minor over a minor chord progression, for instance. It really doesn't matter on which note you start, because the underlying chords let it sound minor or major. Now let me give you an example of this. Listen to this example where the solo is almost identical, but the first progression is in A minor and the second progression is in C major. So far, we handled the two cornerstones of the pentatonic patterns. So now it's time to look at the remaining three patterns. And for that, we are going to split the pattern in two, leaving us with a right side shape and a left side shape. Now learn these one note per string shapes, and we can then build scales by extending the right side and the left side of the cornerstone pattern, like this. Now here we see the extension on the left side pattern with notes from the A minor, a pentatonic scale, creating a brand new pattern which has a lot in common with the pattern that we already learned. So in this way we can extend the pattern we already know to the lower positions, and this makes it very easy to learn a new pattern by heart. Now let's do this also for the right side of the first cornerstone pattern, which looks like this. And again, we extend this one note per string shape with notes from the A minor pentatonic scale to the higher strings, so it becomes a proper two note per string pattern. And we could do the same for the pattern with the root on the fifth string. Splitting this pattern will give us a left side shape, and it will give us a right side shape. And if we extend the right side shape, we'll end up with a pattern we already made with the first cornerstone pattern. So we only need to extend the left side with notes from the A minor pentatonic scale, just like this. So now we have three new patterns based on extensions of the two cornerstone patterns. Super simple and super easy to learn. And the smart thing we did earlier with the cornerstone patterns, like finding the roots and playing simple phrases between them, and of course moving licks from one pattern to the other, that will really help us to remember these patterns too. But I leave that to you. So now I want to tell you one last thing, which is pretty striking and convenient at the same time. This will give you even more insight in the structure of the pentatonic scale patterns. In most of the pentatonic scale patterns, there is a group of three whole step intervals on consecutive strings and a group of two-third intervals on consecutive strings. In the group of whole step intervals, the root note is always the highest note on the middle string of a group of three strings. In a group of third intervals, the root is always the first note on the highest of the two strings. So that's also a great way to quickly learn the pentatonic scale patterns and know where the root is. It's a great asset in learning the pentatonic scale all over the neck. And finally, I want to give you a bonus lick which travels over the three patterns, three of the five patterns we have seen in this video. And it's a nice run over the neck, and I think you can use it very well in your own solos or adapt it to your own needs. So, this concludes this QGenTrack lesson, and I hope you liked it, and I hope it will help you to get further in your quest in being a fantastic guitar player and musician. Don't forget to subscribe so you can get notifications of new tutorials and awesome backing tracks. See you next time in another QGenTrack tutorial.